You can't have like it. You can't have multiple bests. It's not like that song.
Like, can I have you guys like? Can I be like, you're like my La La Land and you're my Moonlight, or like?
Wouldn't I be Moonlight?
No, because I'm not sure.
Jonathan does try to sell me on jazz a lot. It's his. After that meeting, one of the people in there immediately told the press. Big Brother and then like go into the Middle East. We start there. If I'm gonna play, if they're in here doing our reality shows, that's where we start. We have a reality show president. We start there.
Start with Big Brother and then go to the Middle East. That's the history of our country. Am I right? Someone, Big Brother.
Big Brother.
Go.
I've heard of 1984. I haven't read it. I've heard of it. We're talking about leaks. So I know this isn't the case, but I really hope that the reason that these leaks are happening is just that the White House is in such disarray that there's someone who just is running around that they think works for the White House, but it's really just a New York Times reporter. Like, they're just running around like no one's noticing her the whole time. Like, she's wearing a little hat, like a fedora, and a little press badge in it, and John Price is like, someone's been talking to the press! I know it's not you, New York Times lady, you're my best friend. I can trust you. Guys, we're not really close.
Does she have that accent, like the drink coming into the accent world? I go, no worries here, Miss
Say, this is why someone's so stupid today. I'm not gonna tell anybody.
I think if they're not like a reverse Superman, like, I can't be a journalist, she's not wearing glasses. That's
right. Like, he runs into her wearing glasses on the street.
Yeah.
It's like, it's New York Times person, I don't like. I like that. Guys, we're gonna have a great show tonight. Christopher Everett from Wilmington on Fire is here. John McCombs is here.
Yeah.
I got a brand new music class for you guys tonight. Volume is here. We're having a great time. Josh, I'm gonna sit down at the desk. Wanna join me?
I wish we would.
Josh Schwartz, everybody. Power of the town. from black people in this
Yeah, back then it really wasn't a fully controlled black city. It was a mixed up. You had black and white people working together in this thing called fusion politics back then. But you had a white supremacy movement that was not only in Wilmington, man, but just the whole state of Carolina. And it really targeted Wilmington because Wilmington was about the city back then. And they wanted to make Wilmington the capital of this new white supremacy movement. So they had to overthrow the government to do that.
That is insane to think about. And it's also, I'm also a little embarrassed about this. I've lived in this town for about 7 years now. I had not heard of this incident until your movie came out about a year and a half, 2 years ago. This is the first time I ever learned about this. It's very much a somewhat deliberately hidden story.
Yeah, it's, you know, I wouldn't say it's, you know, hidden per se. You know, just have to just look, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's why they look for it. You know, a lot of the elders in this city, they know about it, you know, firsthand, white and black.
Yeah.
And, you know, there have been several books written about it. There have been several scholars who have done lectures on it. And it's all type of, you know, information on the internet. It's just,
so that's just
all
me. I was just like, I didn't know about it.
They brought up compensation years ago. I think it was the North Carolina General Assembly. They developed like a series of bills, I'll say back in 2008,
okay.
when they actually put out the official state report about 1898. And it was a series of bills, man. It was like, you know, putting this history in the school system, paying the film production company $500,000 to do what I did.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Create like two black business districts in Wilmington, like in the Brooklyn area and also Castle Street.
Okay. Yeah.
Kind of revitalize those areas and put black businesses in those areas as well. Different home ownership programs and also compensation to actually direct descendants who had losses back then.
Yeah.
And also put it in school really as well. None of the stuff had passed. You know, none of it. Not even the apology. So there's been an effort, you know, years ago of trying to do this. But you still have some people on the grassroots level who are still trying to do it.
That's insane. That's crazy that not even an apology. Do you have any guesses or speculations like why you would even go that far?
You know, if you apologize, it means that you, like, it's admitted that you've done something. So, you know, it's a legal matter after that. So, but, you know, we're just going to continue to push the story, man, and really push for that as well.
Absolutely. Now, something else I never see about this movie, you released this 2015, right?
Yeah, it's actually released on DVD and digital download this past November, but we've just been doing, like, film festival circuit and also just doing on-screen since November.
Nice. So this is available for you to own and watch.
WilmingtonOnFire.com.
WilmingtonOnFire.com. Please check that out. There was something else that struck me in the film was they talked about the reason that white Southerners were so incensed towards black Southerners is that they had basically just lost the war to former slaves. They lost the war to slaves. They were all slaves in the field. And that kind of, the massacre, the coup d'etat, fueled by this sense of white loss and white rage. So that was just interesting to me to think about, like how far that carries. This past November, I was shocked. Knowing the history, you being more familiar with the history of our state, more familiar with the history of the South. Were you shocked? Were you shocked at this by the election results this year, or was this kind of like? Because it kind of feels like a pattern now.
Yeah, man, I wasn't that shocked. You know, just the past couple of years, you can just sense something, you know what I'm saying? Even right. When he got the nomination, you're like, okay, you know, the first place he got the nomination, honestly.
Right.
But there was a lot. But you know, he catered to a certain demographic that's been overlooked. You know, I'm from a small town of Warrenburg, you know, pretty much rural America. And a lot of those small towns have been hurt for years, you know, once like, one or two factories leave, man, it's a wrap.
Right.
And that's how it's been in my town since, man, I was in elementary school. We've had all types of plants and factories where you could graduate high school, make a decent living, raise your family, or go to college, whatever. It's gone. You know, you have to leave.
Right.
To do so, man. Majority of America are those towns. And, you know, those towns have been overlooked. You know what I'm saying? You have someone like, you know, Trump, and, you know, tells them what they want to hear, mixing in with racism. You know, and the same thing happened in 1898. You know, they really went around the state pumping this white supremacy agenda, blaming, you know, the problems of the average white person, saying it's the Negroes.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's the same pattern.
So having said that, I can't remember who specifically ended up being one of them made the prediction of, since it's pretty much a pattern, you see this thing of propaganda first, then action. This time you performed the master. Do you kind of see this as like another propaganda way that's going to lead to something else? Or
oh yeah, definitely, no doubt, man. You can tell the place that they're talking. Everybody see it. You know, they see Chicago,
yeah.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying. So they've been preparing that. You know what I'm saying. So when they actually do it, everybody's conditioned. Yes, exactly. Everybody's been conditioned all these years to say that, you know, it's crime ridden. You know, they don't put any resources in the place. So you know, it's like very crime ridden. Always has the same, you know, for the past few years. And it's like us, you know, they always tell us as black people, like, it's every black person's fault that Chicago is like that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, but we still, you know, they still target every black person as, you know, Chicago. So you can tell that's the talk.
I think that's a very spot on observation. Christopher Everett, thank you very much for joining us today. Wilmington on Fire, check it out on WilmingtonFire.com, available for on DVD or digital viewing.
That's
right, thank you very much.
Hey, also, you can give me a free copy of the DVD.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. see him perform regularly at the Dead Crow Comedy Room, at least for the next week. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for my good friend and talented comic, John McCombs. That is the best black Trump I have ever seen.
It's not a good one. It's it's not an easy one to do.
I've always been watching before, they're very comic. When did you start doing comedy? Why did you go
to the dude, honestly, that I used to actually go to a Christian camp. I was like straight edge kid when I was small growing up.
Right.
And I used to get like a talent show. I just make jokes about like the counselors and stuff. I make jokes about like when it's in the Bible. I got away with it, so you want a group of people that's not gonna laugh at a joke. It's a group of like hardline, like born again Christians. It's a place to start.
Yeah, I tried to make the Bible jokes when I was a kid. That did not fly.
Yeah, people get really sensitive about like Jesus.
Yeah, it's weird.
Jesse's a fucking moron. Let's give him a machine gun. He's not showing anything special.
Saturday, actually, we're playing Jeremy Allen's down on Wrightsville Beach. And we have an album in the works right now.
Nice.
On that, so that should be out hopefully by the summertime.
All right, very nice. We'll definitely let us know about that. We'll plug that. We'll push that. Guys, we're gonna hear two songs from you guys tonight.
That's right.
I'm very excited about this. I was listening to you guys earlier before the show. You guys are having a lot of fun with it. Ladies and gentlemen, Volume, everybody.
Chasing the Sun.
almost smacked